was close at hand. Worm turned against worm, death's shadow cloaked the land. Where so many would fall, others knew they must follow. Their songs of hope bereft and hollow. For one worm the day had come to take up arms and lead the front. For when he was two, his father left, a soldier subscripted to the military draft. Fodder for the battlefields, father never returned. Now 3 years have passed, for vengeance he yearns. This young worm was gripped with fear. On the eve of battle, his mission was clear. Soldier would the enemy meet. He'll cut them down, he'll make his mark, and then aim Boggy B will strike terror in their hearts. Scrambling up a grassy knoll, he watched the battle taking its toll. With a bazooka in hand, he aimed down its sight, then fired and recoiled as the shell took flight. Chaos and carnage quickly ensued, as worms fell by rank where a mushroom cloud grew. Smoke cleared from the exploding shell. Boggy B observed not all enemies were quelled. Rising out of the hole came the enemy in droves, readying their weapons, glaring up at the knoll. Suddenly there came a deafening great cry, as the worms in the battle looked up to the sky. Thundering down from the heavens above, a screaming iron eagle laden with bombs. Like an avenging angel strafing the field, unleashing bomb after bomb till the enemy was killed. And who should shocked Boggy just happen to see? Why, it was Dad in the cockpit, saluting with glee. That solitary worm stood on the knoll, was joined by his comrades and General Hall. By this incredible feat, the general among them proclaimed Boggy B a hero, a savior, the worm to end wars. And he pinned on a medal so large he fell forwards. As much as young Boggy would like the acclaim, he told of his dad and the war-ending plane. The general to Boggy, chomping on his cigar, said, "Why, son, we've no planes. Don't be modest, you'll go far." Could it be true? Was there really no plane? Was it Dad? Is he dead? Will I see him again? With Boggy still struggling with what he just saw, his buddies around him cheered, "We've won the war!"